Vixen here at WrapSesh, hand solo this week. If you see Slim Shetty's not here, I don't have Amber, I don't have anyone here, it's just me. We're finishing out the week, I don't have any cars in the shop. So we kind of decided this week we would just do a little Q&A. Michael's on a mobile job right now at the detail boss, so it's just gonna be me today. But basically, we got onto our Instagram, which, by the way, our Instagram is where we're popping the most. So if you guys aren't on there, go check us out, Vinyl Vixen Wraps and WrapSesh AZ. So we posted up a live video and some posts and said, hey, we're about to do our YouTube episode today. If you guys have questions, drop a comment, drop a DM, whatever. So yeah, I got a good amount of questions, personal and rap related. So I'm just gonna start blazing through them and hopefully you guys find it enjoyable. First, how old were you when you started? I probably started rapping. Michael started training me. If you guys didn't know, I did an apprenticeship under Michael. I've completely learned under Michael. So all of our methods are kind of developed from him. I started with him about 4 years ago, I wanna say. And then 2 years into my rap career is when we quit our jobs kind of unexpectedly. We were working for another rap shop and then we were like, okay, I guess we're gonna start a shop. So I've been rapping 4 years under Michael, haven't done any certifications, trainings, anything like that. We've always been like apprenticeship style learning. And then we've been running WrapSesh for the last 2 years. Yeah? I think Michael has been installing probably 7 or 8 years, and he's gone between multiple companies, in and out of state. He's been all over the place, very respectable installer. What is your most challenging wrap and why? I'm gonna talk about the wraps that we've done since we've been WrapSesh. So, I mean, I would definitely have to say that our Rocket Lamb Space Jam Aventador SV wrap was probably our toughest one. If you guys remember, if you've been on our YouTube channel, we did 3 or 4 episodes just around the Lamborghini wrap. We were using very, very hard films. We were using a chrome that was laminated, so you're talking 8 to 9 mils thick. We were using an Oracal textured film that had not very good air release, pretty thick. And then we were using a print film that wanted to delaminate because it was a specialty color base. And that was really hard to work with. We had some unexpected issues with that. And then just the full coverage. That's kind of what we specialize in, is doing these full door jams, these 110% coverages. And it's a lot of extra work. Like it's very extensive. Some of these cars we're spending, you know, 2 weeks on. And that's just between the two of us, or when we have help, 3 or 4 people, we're bouncing around doing everything else, running the business. But that car was like a crown jewel for us. And the coverage was really crazy. It was definitely a challenge using all those really thick films and everything, but totally worth the end product in my opinion. I've also worked on cars, like we did a really cool space wrap for another company on a Bugatti. That car was very, very challenging, lining up the prints and just getting the print colors right. We were having problems printing grays and making them look green or blue, or, you know, stuff like that. So yeah, definitely the higher end cars, and when you're using the specialty films, that's definitely where the challenge is at. And then the full coverage. Anything door jams is like level expert in my opinion. It's really tough, not for the faint-hearted installer. I want to start a wrap company. Is it too hard? I would say starting a wrap company is the hardest thing that I've ever done, or that me and Michael have ever done, for sure. There's definitely a lot of challenges. We're still learning how to run a wrap company and how to make money on it. And it's definitely a new experience. We didn't have any business experience background. We are strictly installers and installers first. That's what we did when we started. But we also wear many hats in the company. So I'm doing the accounting, I'm doing the appointments, the sales, the marketing, like everything. It's either me or Michael doing it, and then we have our 2 install helpers. And that's really the gist of it. It is a very rewarding thing though. Just the kind of people we've gotten to meet in the industry, and all the experiences that we've had from it, travel opportunities, things like that, it's definitely worth it in the long run, or at least I'm hoping so. But I wouldn't really want to do anything else. This is my life now. So some people ask us like, oh, are you just in it for the money or whatever? I'm like, what money? Like, I don't care about making money. I don't care about time and I don't care about money. If you notice in our shop, we don't have windows back here. We don't even have clocks. I do not have a single clock up in my shop because to me, it's just like a reflection that we don't care about time. Like, we care about the end product more than anything. And we've really stressed that in our work. And now we're kind of being recognized for that. So that's really cool. When will you offer training? I get asked this a lot. When will you guys offer training? Like, I get offers all the time from people out of state and out of the country that say, hey, let me come down and watch you guys. Let me just shadow you guys for 3 or 4 days and I'll pay you, you know, I'll pay you whatever. Like, I just want to come and watch you and learn. Or we get people that actually want to do like training with us. We're probably the least qualified people to do training. We, like I said, we don't have any certifications. We don't have any formal training. We've always done like apprenticeship style learning. That's how Michael learned. That's how I've learned. I've only learned from him. So we kind of have our own developed method and nothing against training. I've never had any problem with certifications or training. I've just never done it. And I think you can learn. You could definitely learn going to a training course. It's just finding the time and the money to go do it. So training for us, it's probably not something we'll do in the very near future until we secure another location, honestly. Here at this shop, I don't know if you guys have seen our previous episodes, but we actually share the space. This little corner over here is dedicated to Michael's brother, and he does custom printed boxes, small run packaging. And they have loud generators and stuff. Usually in the daytime in here, it can get pretty noisy. And I just wouldn't want to bring someone in here and have them pay me to like teach them how to do something when all the environment is in my control. So maybe in the next year or so, keep an eye out, keep asking me, but probably not right now, guys. You'll have to stick to the YouTube videos. How did you start your shop and fund it? I kind of already went over that. We unexpectedly walked out of our jobs and quit and said, okay, we're gonna start wrapping. And we started wrapping motorcycles in our dining room at our house. We started doing a lot of mobile stuff while we didn't have a shop at first. We were doing jobs for other wrap shops, other companies, you know, all over the place, just getting our foot in the door with people. And from there, we really kind of built our name up. We got in with a lot of the local car clubs. I would definitely recommend hitting them up if you're looking for people to promote your work. Those guys have friends and they like to spend money on their cars regardless of what price tag their car's at, you know? So those are really good people to network with. We would offer basically like partial sponsorships where we would do like the material at wholesale and the install at a discounted price. You know, a good hookup price when you're first starting, just to get your name out there and get a rap out there. And once you impress those guys, they're gonna go tell all their friends at every show every weekend. So we've gotten a lot of business from just catering to our car clubs. We sponsor a few local Arizona car clubs. We extend like a 10% discount to the team members and we make all their decals. You see I'm making some decals right now here. And then just social media. Having a social media presence was huge for building our name. As far as funds, we started our company with $0. We did not have any loans. We didn't have any handouts. We didn't have any money to start out with. We didn't have savings at all. Actually, right when we quit our jobs and started our company, we had just moved into a new house. And that house is very expensive for us. I don't even know how we managed to get through the year lease. But there were times, honestly, like, you wanna talk about grind? There were times that, like, in the winter that I had our power off at our house for 3 weeks. We had no hot water for 3 weeks, and we were cooking foil dinners outside, and we had our food in an ice chest. Like, no joke. We had to go to food banks for a little bit. We had to sell 3 of our project cars, 1 of my bikes, a couple guns, like all sorts of stuff, just to get by and pay the bills and make this happen. So we've really prided ourselves on that. We've built ourselves from the ground up with no investor, no money, no business loan, no anything. It's all just been through grinding. So I think that's pretty cool. Next one, do you allow the public to come by your shop? Yes, we do. We try to advertise ourselves as appointment only because a lot of times we're running around and we're mobile and we're not always here in the shop, you know, Monday through Friday. So we like when people schedule appointments with us, but we do have walk-ins. We do welcome the public. We also welcome installers. So if you guys are installers or you're a shop or whatever and you are in town in Arizona, please come by and see us. We would love to sesh with you. We'd love to hang out and chat. Like, we are all about networking and making friends in the industry. And if you guys are our followers, you're our supporters more than anything. So we love meeting you guys and hanging out. It's so great getting to go to the big shows, SGIA, SEMA, RapsCon, things like that, and meeting all your followers, because these are the people that are supporting you every day. And they're giving you inspiration for raps, and they're you're giving them advice. And I spend like, literally, when I get home, I spend hours responding to messages of people asking me questions. They're asking us for advice. How should I tackle this? What's your opinion on this? Like, we really go and spend a lot of time trying to better the industry and help people out. Like, we're not hush-hush about anything. You ask me a question, I'm probably gonna tell you the answer. Like, I don't really hide stuff like that. So we've had shops come from Canada, Colorado, Seattle, you know, all over the place, and we've got a lot of followers internationally now that they want to come by. So if you guys want to come and meet us, please come to our shop if you're ever in the Phoenix, Arizona area. Most definitely, you are welcome here. So tomorrow, which is August 17th is Michael's 28th birthday, Slim Shetty. But I want to show you guys the stuff that I got for Michael because I just think it's really cool. So you guys remember I told you, Michael's brother Bobby, he does custom printed boxes over here in this corner. So this is the box that he made for Michael for his birthday. So it's got my own business now, bitches. That was his idea, not mine. Got the WrapSesh logo on there. I haven't even boxed up the present yet. I don't know if you guys are familiar with a place called Bookman's. I don't know how many of them there are. I think there's two or three here in Arizona. Oh. Happy birthday, Slim Shetty, Slay Major Color this year. Super cool. So thanks, Bobby. His business is called The Custom Box. Okay, so back to my story. Bookman's, it's like buy, sell, trade for all things awesome. So they've got movies, they've got old school gaming consoles, they've got books, they've got collectibles, figurines, all sorts of nerdy stuff, albums, instruments. And you go there and you can buy it, or you could trade stuff in when you get bored with it. It's a pretty awesome store, one of my favorites. So I got him something. We're really into like old school gaming consoles. We have like three Nintendo 64s. We've got a PlayStation, Xbox, Dreamcast, quite a few of them. I mean, there's a lot at our house. But this was something relatively new that I did not know about that they happen to have, and it's called a Retrobit. It's just it's a console that plays Nintendo, Super Nintendo, and Sega Genesis. Yeah, Genesis. And it comes with its own controllers, but it's also right here somehow. Yeah. Right here, you can actually plug in all the old controllers too. So I got some of the old school Nintendo controllers. I'm just so excited over this. Like, I love this like nostalgic stuff. I grew up on a Nintendo 64. So these games are just a tiny bit before me, but I think he's gonna really like them. So I got him that whole console. And then mostly Mario stuff. What we get? Yoshi's Cookie. Never even played that one. This one's a try game. It's got Duck Hunt, Super Mario Bros., and Track Meet. Super Mario 2. Super Mario Bros. All versions of Mario. Also, we got Top Gear. And Genesis, we got Taz, Escape from Mars. And Sonic the Hedgehog. I love Sonic. So I'm super excited for these. Make sure you guys wish Slim Shetty a happy birthday. It's August 17th, it's his 28th birthday. Follow our Instagram and Facebook, Vinyl Vixen Raps and WrapSesh AZ if you want to support the WrapSesh vibe. I can't dance while I'm sitting. And we'll see you guys next week, yeah?